Hello, everybody. Welcome to game two of the Flying Snakes versus Slayers. Slayers managed to take the first game. YJ, you ready for this game two?
Yes, I am kind of ready. Guys, stay hydrated. Drink water. Please donate.
YJ lives in a hut in Singapore, so he cannot afford water. We have some secret intel here. Clowny isn't the right word. Slayers has a unique draft.
Oh no.
What are you seeing already?
Oh no, they're gonna pick punch next.
Why? Talk to me about this.
Oh, it's gonna be Alchemist gonna give Lifestealer the eggs.
5 seconds. Okay.
Gonna get like punch.
Who does
storm
he eat?
Spirit.
Reserve time. Does he eat punch. The Alchemist?
Each punch.
Eat Pudge.
Eat Pudge.
And then infest into the Storm Spirit or whoever the vehicle is?
Yes, yes. Or Space Cow.
Flying Snakes, the very smart second pick. They pick up that AA. They know that Lifestealer wants that sustain. But this may be something like a support Lifestealer. They may be going, some sort of wacky route, trying to mislead.
10 seconds. Ancients Alchemist. All right. Ancients Alchemist. Solo Mid Nyx.
I mean, perhaps we're thinking a little too off the rails here. It may just be a...
Hey, not really. I've seen 5K MMR Southeast Asian players play Ancients Alchemist.
Well, and not only that, but this draft was... From what I've been told, this draft was conceived by Bearham. And he's a very greedy player. Very greedy player. He always finds somewhere to farm, even if it's cliff jungling on the Ancients. So, I wouldn't put it past them. Considering the way Rawls played last game, he was really smart on that Ricky and able to be where he needed to be when he needed to be there. I think he could absolutely do some weird stuff on the Ancients. So, we see the bans here coming out. I want to comment that the Ursa ban in the opening round that Slayers did was immediate. They did not think about that practically at all. They just banned Ursa without thinking. So I'm wondering that's going to be a counter to whatever they're looking to go into.
Yeah, Ursa already naturally counters Nyx and Alchemist.
I suppose so, yeah. Both of those heroes want to go toe-to-toe with him and can't do that Ursa against Ursa.
Fuzzy Wuzzy, man.
You need to build the draft around dealing with the Ursa, and clearly they want to go in a different direction with this.
Yeah, Flying Snakes banning up. Oh, I told you it's gonna be the punch. It's gonna be that strat. All the Space Cow, all the Storm Spirit. Or if they wanna go for the ballsy move, like the Mineski style ballsy move, they go for the Queen of Pain. Oh, they react with a Void, which is a good counter against the double bombs with Stopping Time.
Yeah, it turns out Stopping Time, pretty potent ability.
Yeah.
We've got YJ cosplaying as Oracle here, predicting these drafts. What will be next, oh wise one? Do they take the vehicle now, or do they take that as their last pick?
They should take the vehicle with the last pick, because they have a lot of vehicles to choose from. What they should look to get right now is something that can supplement this. Maybe... they want to get like a Spectre or Zeus or Furion that could help with the bombs, because you have some sort of global threat. Oh, they're doing the invisible bomb! Oh no!
Wow!
They're doing the invisible bomb!
Not only that, but there's your global presence, right? You get the Alchemist, who's just going to be an Ags farming machine. He's going to give the Ags to Lifestealer. If he gives an Ags to Tree and Protector, I don't know that he'll necessarily do this, but that's going to give Tree and Protector global presence. And they force very Flying smart. Snakes to take the Storm Spirit, because they know that they don't want to spend a ban on it. I think that they're probably comfortable playing Storm Spirit against Alchemist if they think he's going to be mid. But I think that this is just so volatile from Slayers that any of these heroes, you have no idea how they're going to lane this, because, again, this could all just be a misdirect, and it could be something else that they go for as their core, and this is all just meant to be, you know, smoke and mirrors.
Yeah, they have really good level 1 gank potential. They can smoke and steamroll anybody that's not Faceless Void. Right now, Slayers can do that. They have three slows. They have Alchemists, okay? And Trimfler hits you in the face for 100 damage, Well, it's like 91 at level 1, but still, that's
a lot of damage.
100 damage. A lot of damage. Okay, he's gonna punch you, and Lifesteal is gonna like claw you, and then you're dead if you're not Faceless Void.
Excuse me, this is going to be a ban that Flying Snakes is probably going to spend most of their reserve time thinking about. This is a very crucial play for them. If you're Slayer, well, never mind, they just go right for the Axe. I don't think that was a vehicle that Slayers was looking for, though.
Yeah, but Axe does present a lot of opportunities, but because they pick Treant Protector Alchemist, okay, it's not going to be the Axe Nyx Bomb. It's going to be something very mobile. So Storm Spirit was one of them that the Flying Snakes picked up. Spirit Breaker is one, but he can be countered very easily. The last one on the charts would be something like a Queen of Pain, okay? Because she provides, I've seen this being played in a few games already. You take out the Queen of Pain, it provides you the Blink, it provides you the Magic Burst coming out from Scream and Sonic Wave to follow up. So you get that as well as the double Infest Bomb.
And I think that if they can get that initiation, even if Flying Snakes plays this really smart, they stay grouped up as five the whole time from, you know, minute five, and they try to just dodge these ganks wherever possible, it's still going to be easy for Slayers. They can get that Treant Protector to go invis in the back lines and then just start, you know, picking off the Ancient Apparition, pick off the Elder Titan, disrupt the Faceless Voids initiation. I mean, man... One thing I will comment on, though, okay, they opt for the Slark. I noticed that there are four strength heroes on the board for Slayers right now. A Timbersaw could be real. Oh, never mind. They banned out the Timbersaw first.
Timbersaw.
They knew where they were going with this.
Undying.
Undying. Ooh, I really like the Undying.
Undying.
But they
Undying's really good.
That hard
carry. Undying's really good. It doesn't die to Acid Spray. It doesn't die to Rot. It blocks Meat Hook. It ignores zombies ignore Overgrowth. And zombies eat living armor. So Undying is a good pickup. But the thing is that if you go the Nyx Bomb build and you aim Undying first, he's not gonna be there because Undying is a sustained kind of hero. He has to be there at the back of the fight, only going in front line when he has, like, I don't know, 5 decay charges and then he goes in.
And not only that, if he was the hero that they pick up there, I don't know how they lane this. Would they stick the Void safe? Storm mid, obviously, and then stick the Undying in the offlane? That just feels too mid-game centric against a lineup with a Lifestealer and an Alchemist. I feel like you're going to wind up being in a lot of trouble late game.
Yeah.
So I think the Slark works.
You think the Slark works. In my opinion, depending on how Slayers picks up their last hero, Slark may not work, okay? So Slark's a good hero because he's very mobile. He has very good sustain due to Shadow Dance, Dark Pact. He has good mobility. As I said earlier, and he has Essence Shift, which lets him fight in sustained team fights. The thing about Slayer is that they have Burst Magic, and then they have instant punches. Okay, they punch you twice, and you are supposed to die after the Infest Bomb. If you don't, then you probably win the team fight. But in Slark, they're using the bear. They're gonna run in with the bear.
I like this a lot. I was just gonna run in. On the fact that the Ancient Apparition, they took that early on to try to deny the, you know, early aggression. I'm sorry, not the early aggression. That sustained teamfight that Lifestealer and Alchemist are both going to want with their regen. But with a lone druid pickup now, it's almost looking like they have these four that are going to run this wacky strategy. And then there's a lone druid there who can just farm. He can get his 12 slot. He can, you know, be relevant late game. And he's going to be able to just farm. Or, like you said, they can use the bear as the vehicle.
Yeah, it's going to be like 3,200 HP bear later on or something. Oh, 2,700. But, okay, so Radiance Carrier, the bear. Okay. And so, I don't know. Do they want to build Dagon this game? Dagon Punch? Do they want to go the Warcraft Tree strat?
I mean, it supports their idea, right, of getting that big burst damage. It's really cheeky. I mean, the draft is cheeky to begin with. You know, the whole thing just reeks of cheek.
Okay, they aren't doing the level 1 smoke gank, which I think would be very amazing. Which they can pick off, like, I don't know, 4 kills or something. Well, they have a slug, so I think that's the reason why they don't want to do that. But still... they can go for a level 1 smoke. They actually have a smoke on the punch. They could go for like the level 2 smoke once you have Nature's Guise and Leech Seed and you get Rage or Feast and Open Wounds. Oh no, they could this could go downhill for Flying Snakes once it hits 4 minutes.
And if he does a good job of not showing here, then this is going to catch Team Flying Snakes totally by surprise. They have no idea where the Pudge is. They can probably anticipate that he's hanging out up here. But, yeah, and we see the pings coming out at the exact same time I ping it. So they know he's there. They're going to be careful to dodge the hook. But, and there's the hook.
Oh, he's dead. He's dead. He's dead. He's dead. He's dead.
See you later, bees. He has the one shared tango. But this first kill is going to go to follow me.
Oh, God. It's already giving them so much of an advantage. That the lone druid got it. That means what? Boots for the bear?
Yeah, we'll see what he's going to do with that gold. Looks like he's going into the offlane. Interesting.
Okay, smart. Smart. They're playing it. They're playing it like how they would. Play a normal game. ETAA. Pudge is going to be hammered down. With all of that.
But Follow Me seems pretty content to just walk up here and just send the bear in. You know, who needs anything else? The bear can do the work for you. He has the stout shield. He's very tanky. And it's just going to be fine for him. He's got a Pudge in the lane as well. Ooh, as I disconnect. Unfortunate.
You disconnect?
I disconnect. All right,
so yeah, there's a Pudge in the lane. But he's okay. The bear just doesn't want to get pounced by Slark because he does have only 580 HP. How about Venom on the Spirit Bear first instead of the boots? So okay, they're just playing as normal. Could come a hook. Yeah, they could get a hook on the AA soon. If Pudge really wants it. Actually no, they go for ET, but Pudge doesn't have Rot.
And even considering that, they already got the first blood for their team, so there's no major pressure on them to make anything major happen in this lane.
He's doing the manly build. Punching the faceless void. Oh, he's not even time walking. He's just tanking it like a man. Oh no! He's baiting, trying to bait the Treant to go on the tower. Rouse, man, with the Treant. This is what I love to see with support Treant players. You don't go around, living armoring people. You go in, you punch their offlane in the face.
you take advantage of that massive base damage that Treant has.
Look at that, look at that. Oh, look at that! If he had Leech Seed and it wasn't a faceless void. Oh, things would have been so different now. Okay, Pudge trying to go for the hook. He's level 2. And ET is actually going to walk right into him. And he's dead. Like, he's dead. Is AA dead? Oh shit, I think AA is dead.
I'm not sure what that hook was.
What the heck? Okay.
Argus doesn't get the deny, but there is, I don't know. A bit weird, I don't know what that hook was all about.
He thought the AA was gonna move, but he played like a pro. Remember what Dendy said? How to dodge hooks so you stand still.
Good advice, and it paid off for him there.
Oh no, ET is dead again! Oh no, he's dead again! The exact same strategy! Oh no!
Oh, this poor Elder Titan, he's not even level 2 yet. He doesn't even have Stomp. And now that's 3 kills, 4 kills into the pockets of Slayers.
Oh god, that is like Pudge has 4 Flesh Sheep stacks and it's only 3 minutes.
And not to mention the fact that Follow Me is now level 3. He's got the level 2 bear already. He already has the recall.
But at least there's a ward there, so, you know.
Yeah, they can see him, but fat lot of good that's going to do him.
What fucking bot lane, man? The Treant walking up to the faceless void. This level 1 bash, but Tree just hits so hard. And ET decides he's gonna abandon the lane as level 1 Windlace. Oh no.
And he's close to level 2.
He got spotted by Alchemist, and he's not gonna get this rune. So it's gonna be still level 1. It's gonna wobble back. A punch! So deep! Even scanning, oh my god, this game.
But something witty was smart there with that. I don't know if he was the one who used the scan, but Flying Snake's very smart to use the scan and, you know, say, hey, maybe this Pudge is here. And, you know, something witty doesn't push forward and keeps himself safe.
You so can try and hold in between the creeps or slump.
I missed a couple minutes of this opening here. How's mid lane going? It looks like the CS war favors the Storm Spirit just a touch. He's up by 21 versus 12.
To 12. It's not just a touch. It's like two waves, man.
I suppose so, yeah. I mean, yeah. I guess that makes sense of a melee versus a ranged. I also want to point out that we see Tip to Strippers, who was playing the Lion last game, is now taking up the mid role. Follow me now in the off lane. And Spork playing the safe lane lifestealer. Yeah, there he is.
Yeah, it's good. It's okay, alright? Because first things first, Alchemist is a support Alchemist this game.
Yeah. I mean, we still don't know how the mid game's gonna go. Is he going to, you know, transition into a support, or is he going to try to keep farming and also get those Ag Scepters up?
He's gonna farm for the Ag Scepters.
Smoke from Arcless coming into mid lane. He is now behind. Yeah. He's on the other side of the river. If he gets a hook onto bees,
Storm's level 6. Oh, Alchemist, no! Nice living armor to save the day.
And now if only they had that global presence that we talked about. Bees with 127 yep. HP. Really clutch play from Valkyrie there to make sure that his Storm Spirit gets out alive. I was a little questioning him because, you know, those two deaths in top. I think that the second one was definitely avoidable, but, you know, it's the same thing where you say, well, they did it to me once. There's no way they'll do it again. And then they do it again, and then you just feel kind of foolish. Is the bear going to die? No, he managed to get away from the cold feet.
Yeah, it's running on 4-2-3. Gets resummoned. Gonna smash the slug in the face. He doesn't have the ulti just yet. He needs one more creep to die. And Pudge goes home with the neutral creep express.
Choo Choo picking up his straggle boots, working towards them with the wind lace now as well. Tip to Strippers, only 15 last hits.
Yeah, I mean, you're supposed to lose the lane against a storm like that. But when you hit the level 6, that's when you can start snowballing. And he even stacked the own camp. So he's going to get that extra bit of Grievous Greed for his troubles.
I'm not sure why he isn't stacking that camp again. He could very easily just throw an acid spray at it to let it stack, but I guess he would rather have this farm in the mid lane and then transition to that later.
Oh no. Nyx is going Radiance first.
Wow.
Oh, no boots, Nyx. Oh, it's huge. He's definitely going Radiance. If he's going Aghanim's, he would have bought the Ogre Axe first. Look at the wards, man. They're so afraid of the Pudge. They have to place the wards like this because they kept dying in the top lane.
And the funny part is that, you know, we see that he is up here, but he hasn't been for so long. There's the hook on
something.
Oh,
he gets the hook.
Something witty does get off the cold feet, and then the pounce from Avril onto Follow Me. Follow Me looks
nice.
Like he's going to be okay. He roar. Gets the roar.
He purges the roar, but still, come on, you can do it. Nice root by the bear. Pudge is running for his life. If he gets smacked one more time, he could look for the deny. Instead, he opts to deny himself right now, gets it off, and the lone druid will not be dying so soon. Or will he? Will there be any TPs? No pounce. 1 second to pounce. Comes up, gets it off. There we go.
I think he could have gotten away with that if he was a little bit quicker. He could have dropped an iron branch and eaten the tree and then kept walking. Because he had to know that that damage was up, and he was pretty close to surviving that, especially with the extra armor imparted by his true form. So maybe if he was a bit quicker, but...
Here comes the
Pudge. Ooh, Blind Hook doesn't get anything for his troubles. And now Rawl's walking into the jungle. He doesn't have any points in Nature's Guise yet, just drops that Obs Ward, and it does get scouted out, so that's going to be dewarded probably immediately. Something witty. Not with the gold for sentries, though.
Storm over here gonna pick up what's that? Courier going to the secret shop for him. Arcanes? Going Arcanes this game.
So odds are he's gonna go Arcanes, then transition into the Bloodstone, disassemble the Arcanes and get the Soul Booster.
Okay, so it's definitely a Radiance Nyx.
Yeah, they're just content to let him farm down here. I don't know if this is the play, but they seem to be pretty okay with it. The Void now in the jungle. Swaggu just trying to get what farm he can. He has Chrono online.
And it's one key goal.
Bees at the same time free firing middle. So it's tough to say. I don't know. Tip to Strippers has retired to the jungle. 33 last hits. He's going for the armlet first. It's a bit tricky. Not how to
play
this.
Yeah, it is. I think the only thing they have to deal with is going to be the Storm Spirit eventually. They need something to stop him, probably a Dismember. But they also need to dismember things like Slark, you know?
Yeah, they need a lot of lockdown against Flying Snakes. And you know what's funny is the Void, which fits so well in Flying Snakes' draft, because he is that hero who can set up the Cold Feet, he can set up the Stomp, he can set up the Earth Splitter. He would fit so well on Slayer's team as well. You know, that big lockdown to deal with the Storm, make sure it doesn't zip away, make sure the Slark can't get away. And even if they try to build Silence Sticks, there's going to be a Purge from the Slark, and there's going to be a Storm who could go BKB or Manta or Yules to try to purge that.
Oh, Tree, wow, survives. Snatching the Invis Rune.
And just barely getting away.
We'll take that. Now Storm without any bottle charges. If he gets, oh, never mind. We see in the top lane gonna be some action. Lone Drizzt gonna start running. He gets off the roar on Tree, doesn't buy a TP. Instead, opts to have the Slark falls, and will Pudge die in his steed. Oh, the Storm was cancelled, and now you can just suicide if you want.
He doesn't even need to.
Yep.
He's just gonna walk away and let the Tranquils heal him
so
up.
So, one for nil, and that's your safe lane carry.
Not only is it your safe lane carry, it's your Slark, who is the guy who needs to come up big in the late game. That's like, that's gonna be so huge. If they can shut down the Slark and then allow this snowball to get going through the mid game, it's gonna be very, very scary for them to deal with.
Oh god, he has 3,500 gold. Oh, but in the top lane, Storm Spirit's here. We see the roar coming in. Is it enough? Yes, it is enough. Storm Spirit with a failure of a gank there will be wasting his time, letting the Alchemist actually catch up. But Pudge in the position for a hook. But I don't think he wants to take this. He should understand that all of the cores are top. And he's gonna just hide in the trees. Oh, Follow Me is very ballsy as well. Not in true form. Yeah, they have to back up right now.
I'm over here.
Whoa. The Storm Spirit coming in deep. Come on. 3 seconds for it. Oh, he actually survives. Instead, the Pudge will die.
I think you're okay with the Pudge going down there instead of the Lone Druid for sure.
Ooh, yeah.
Leap through the tower range. It was tricky for Bees because he got there and he just didn't have the mana. He maybe overestimated his abilities, but by the time he got there, he couldn't really jump in because he was sitting at about 1/3 mana. He has the mana boots, he has the soul ring, and he had the bottle charges. It's just he didn't manage his mana well enough to be able to.
Oh! Secret relic. Oh god. I hear a dismember. It's not gonna kill the storm. He's gonna blink out. We do have a hook. He's not gonna get anything there. Wrong angle, my friend.
He's not giving up though. Argus wants this.
On blind hope, you can do it. Something? No.
Opting not. And now, in all this time, Tip to Strippers has managed to pick himself up a nice chunky bit of farm. He's up to 63 last hits now. He's got 2,000 gold in the bank and.
Oh, he's farming the eggs. He's getting the eggs right now. I can feel it.
I can sense it. It's there somewhere.
Yep, somewhere
needs to be
deep,
seen.
Deep in his heart. He's buying it now!
He is going for it, so you called it! It's gonna be the eggs onto Lifestealer.
Oh my god, it's the invisible bear Lifestealer bomb? What?
Argo's likely
Pudge
to go
in a
down
bad position.
Here.
Yeah, at least try and get a kill. Kill the AA before you die. How about that? They ignore him? He hooks a creep out.
I don't understand why Avril didn't go in there. He could have just pounced onto the Pudge and pressed Q and he's pretty okay.
I think he thought it was an illusion or something. Like, why would there be a Pudge there when he knows that we're... I don't know, man. I don't know.
And there is also the Midas on the bear. He picked that up.
Avoid farming for Blink first. What do you think about that?
Tricky call. I like it in this game specifically because they are aware of the fact that there is no major lockdown for Slayers. So if they can get a Chronosphere to disrupt the fight, not even to get kills out of it, but just to you know, plant it down in the middle of the fight and say, you guys can't take the initiation that you want onto either our Slark or our Storm Spirit anyway. So that only leaves the supports and the Void. So I think getting the Blink for good positioning will help him to keep his squishy supports alive, and it'll help to set up for the fight that Flying Snakes wants versus the fight that Slayers wants.
And we're almost there, level 11, so that's level 2 Infest. And that means he can go and pick up, like, I don't know, Gary, the ancient Granite Golem.
Gary, he has a name?
Yes, Gary the... yeah, Gary.
This is news to me.
Oh, in the top lane, Punch though, gonna melt down, he at least gets a hook off. Wow, in Shadow Dance, and now Lone Druid's dead because Storm Spirit's coming from the back end. You see the roar, but it's not gonna be of any use. It was just bad play by both the Pudge and the Lone Druid. They shouldn't be in so deep.
Yeah, you look at their vision, and where is it? They have no wards on the map right now, not a single one, and they're still trying to dive all the way back to here. I don't know about that. Maybe getting a little too carried away. And now they're going to lose their top tower for it. Oh, and the jump in from Bees. He wants Arglis. He's going to be able to go in here. He gets the pull. But Pudge is fairly tanky. There's going to be some right clicks coming from the AA. The Slark misses the pounce. The Dark Pact will get him. Avril now taking a few tower shots.
Yeah, he should have just thrown the hook back. Try and kill the Slark in return. But honestly, Radiant's up on lifesteal.
Honestly, I don't think he anticipated the dive so deep from the Slark. I wouldn't have gone that far if I was the Slark, but I guess they did get the kill for it. I want to talk about the Radiance for just a second. Specifically against the Void, Void is a hero with his Time Walk where he wants to be going in and out of the fight, purging off all the damage he's taken in the last 2 seconds, and he wants that skill to always be on cooldown. And instead, ooh, we're going to see a stomp onto the Lifestealer. Are they going to commit the Chrono here? Yes, Swaggoo does spend
misplay,
it. We're going to see the AA
misplay
coming over top.
By Nyx.
All he all he has to do is infest this creep. Oh,
he
had infested. I think
Oh, the lifesteal? Oh, close. Oh, punching! 2 for 2? 2 for 2.
2 for 2, and I think a favorable trade for Slayers, because now the Chrono is cool on cooldown. Now the Earth Splitter is on cooldown, and the Ancient Apparition ult, though it's short, is on cooldown.
Oh, the punch kills off the A. Next up, E.T. Will he get the dismember? No, he doesn't see him. Instead, hook is up in 1 second. Could be looking to throw the biggest hook of his life.
Ooh.
Gets juked.
Smart play. They both went for the level 1. Arglis went for the juke and then throwing in the same spot. Like you said, best way to dodge a hook? Stand still. No, sir. Arglis tried that trick once. Not going to work a second time. Or excuse me. Arglis tried to avoid that play from being made on himself.
Yep.
But it doesn't work out.
It's going to be the Lifestealer's eggs. Here we go. Give me eggs. And yep, you are really compelled. All right, assimilate. Rot and assimilate. And then infest the tree. Oh, he's doing it. He's rotting. Oh, there's a punch inside the Lifestealer. Oh, he's going for the tree. He's going for... Oh, he's actually going for Thomas, the Ancient Thunderhide.
So for those of you who don't know, this is the Ags upgrade of the Lifestealer.
Oh, it's Thomas, the Ancient Thunderhide.
He's able to take another unit and put it inside of himself. And if Pudge does it with Rot on, it deals the damage, though there is no visual effect, and Pudge does not take damage. Ooh, pick off on Follow Me in bot lane.
Yeah, the thing about this is that it's gonna walk. He doesn't have PP. He's just gonna slowly walk towards every lane he sees. He sees the Slark.
He sees Slark, but they have no way to lock him down.
Slark hears it. He hears the rotting.
They're just not gonna be able to catch him.
Yeah, they need to do this in a lane. They want a 5-man push. Like, just 5-man push a lane and just do this. Okay, not the other way around.
Especially trying to fight around the Chronosphere, you know? They need to take advantage of the opportunity. Both teams need to take advantage of the timings of Chronosphere. You want to see Flying Snakes take advantage of when it's off cooldown and just that threat of the team fight. And you want to see Slayers take advantage of when they know it's on cooldown and then try to take the fight to Flying Snakes.
But right now, aren't doing anything. Just walking around with the Ancient Thunderhide. Tier 2 is being hit down. There's Midas on the bear. That's great.
And they're spending a lot of time infested here.
Holy shit, they have two Midases on the bear! Is under attack.
12 slot bear?
Oh my god! Just double Midas! One for each hand!
12 slot bear, it's happening!
Oh god, here comes the Ancient Thunderhide!
We do see Storm jump in onto Rawls up top. All he needs to do is give himself the Nature's Guise. You gotta be fine. Bees with no detection. Is under attack. And the Shadow Blade now done on Avril.
They're not making this work. Okay, they have to push a lane. They have to 5-man push. This is how you cheese. Okay, you 5-man push a lane, you make them die. You don't go for the faceless void. He's just gonna blink or time walk out.
Well, the point is they have to do something, right? Like, look at all this time that they're spending just infested in the Ancient Thunderhide. And this is time that Pudge isn't getting levels. This is time that Lifestealer isn't getting levels. And
no, they actually get levels. Tower. Yeah, they actually get levels and EXP.
They've been so far away from all the action that, I mean, only now are they starting to get some last hits and some farm.
Tranquil Boots. Frenzy. He can just go and eat... You can just go and eat, like, the ancient, another kill on the tree and by the slant this time. Come on, you're not making use of your ancient Chrono Spear in the mid lane. Alchemist gonna go down, Ice Blast as well. And where is the Clown Strat? Irrelevant to the game right now because not making full use of it.
They're trying to get this push down this tower, but they haven't even gotten it yet. And now we're gonna see Storm Spirit TP back. And we may see both of these heroes are going to be in trouble soon. Arglis gets the dismember, and now we're going to see why isn't Lifestealer popping out? All it takes is that infest, and he could have had the damage onto bees. They're going to chase it. He pops out just a second too late. They will get the tower, but no one getting the last hit, so that's extra gold going to waste. I don't know. I'm looking at the net worth chart, and it peaked in favor of Slayers, but then there's a very long, like I want to say 10-minute period, where it just stagnated, and it's not going anywhere.
Yeah, they can't do anything like this.
Meanwhile, there's a Shadow Blade finished on Avril.
They're doing the same thing already. Gonna get the Assimilate. And then, what are they gonna get? They should get the Ancient Black Dragon. But,
There's no creeps here to even stack. He's gonna try to stack it, but they should really go into Rawls and start using that Invis.
Yeah.
Midas on him as well. I guess they're trying to have the backup strat of having all these Midases.
Oh, yeah, okay. It's gonna be the Ancient Black Dragon. That's at least what he can get.
And that is a lot better because this fireball makes it so effective to push because it's just able to lay down an area and say, you don't get to be here. Too bad, so sad. We see pings coming out for top lane.
Do they want to rotate? There's nice vision on the side of Snakes. So they see the Alchemist who's going for the second axe. That should be the Treant's axe. There's a Midas on the tree. There's a Midas on the both bears. A lot of Midases, very greedy. Here comes the Storm Spirit. But he can't deal a lot of damage against the dragon because it is magic immune. Instead of, you should just walk next to the storm. That's not how you use the cheese strat. You walk next to the storm. And then you just follow him around until
he
dies.
Well, I think they're more looking for... They don't necessarily want the kill here. They're trying to rotate more heroes up. The bear is in the neighborhood.
That's what they can kill. But the ET, though. ET is the one they can kill. They can do it right now if they want to.
They're just waiting so long to pull the trigger on this. Rawls does have vision, and he's got the ult.
There's a Slark coming in from the top as well. Slark and AA. They're gonna try and man fight this. They have Silver Age on the slot. They have to fight inside the fireball. Oh, he assimilated out! What a misplay there by the Pudge. Not what you wanna see. Not like this, not like this. Not like this. No, this is not how you play the cheese strat, man. Come on. Now it's just the Radiance, not the Raw. He's given up. Gets Chrono. Didn't even rage. He goes down.
in the AAL to overtop, just for good measure.
Who has the eggs? Lone Druid has the eggs. Why? Don't.
Well, maybe this is going to be the synergy now. They're going to allow this bear to travel around more and, you know, do whatever he wants, wherever he wants, and they can start infesting into him instead of one of these ancients.
Are they buying an abyssal blade on the bear?
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Buying an abyssal blade on bear.
I guess it could make sense to give them that extra little bit of initiation. They can abyssal someone and then have the pudge pop out. But that's a pretty expensive item, and they're not going to get it online anytime soon.
Exactly. Radiance is up. Aghanim's is up. I think Aghanim's on the tree would have been better, so he can start planting. Just five Obzorts.
And that's going to make it hard for Avril, because he's going to rely on his ult to scout out where the vision is. If he starts putting trees everywhere, they're going to force TFS to get a gem.
Gosh.
Man, this is quickly falling apart for Slayers. You see
that
they're
doing the best right now, but like it's the tree man, and here comes the fastest bear in the world. But that's not where everyone is. There's an arcane rune down there. That's what they see. But Lone Druid activates the arcane rune. All right then, less cooldown on entangling roots. Yeah, they can. They can go in this and they can kill all three of them. A first smart play. Smart. Nice fear. That's one kill. Next kill should be the ET. Nice. Infest. Pop out. That doesn't even need it. Follows the Slark around. But the Sorcery comes up. And now he's not gonna care. He's gonna run into the tree. He's gonna fight the Slark. I'm gonna find the Slark. We're gonna pop out. He just. Okay.
Not gonna find
and
it.
And now Tree and Protector though. This could be the thing that they will be looking for. The fear could come out, yes, the roar, and now Invis on the Treant. He doesn't have any mana left. There's no mana left. And this is just going to be the steamroll. The Chronospear up, but he's dragging the bear out of the Chronospear! Oh, jeez Louise, there goes with the root. Time Walk could be coming in sometime soon, but it's not going to be enough because the bear is just going to steamroll him. The fear is there with the Savage Roar, and they get a 4-man kill out of nothing?
1200 gold! It's something!
No ET and AA are gonna show up! They're gonna show their faces! And the bear's gonna come in! It's gonna be a 2-man kill! He dodges the stomp! He's dead! He's dead! The 5-man kill! They're gonna get frozen in place! Yes, they are, but the ET is gonna walk in! No? Yes, the bear has 29 regen a second with the living armor! He goes into minus degrees! He's earning gold from the Lone Druid, who actually shift queued himself to clear every camp, so his hero is being safe.
And now you know what's funny is all he has to do is press Q, and this Spirit Bear is safe. So both of these heroes that are infested inside are also going to be safe. So they have the potential to make this work. You know, again, we see all this regen coming out. The bear much tankier than the ancients, and able to land the towers really effectively. The question is it going to be enough?
He's actually building a Maelstrom instead of the Abyssal Blade. So I'm not too sure about that. I thought getting a Abyssal on the bear. Oh no, ET is fucking dead. Oh, here he comes. The biggest bear. The meanest one in town. Here comes the stomp and the roar to cancel the stomp. And now here we go. But time dilation does not work on units. It's safe. You can't look at that living armor, man. Oh,
and he's totally fine. Look at this. He's only got 8 armor, and he's got the the Vanguard.
Oh, Restalin's the bear. I mean, Recall's the bear. Yeah, you said he has 8 armor. So much regen. Storm Speed kills up the Alchemist.
Which, you know, at this point is fine. He's building up a Maelstrom. He's gonna have to be careful here. He's got the Bloodthorn, but. I'm sorry, he's got the Orchid. They're just going to keep whittling him down.
OG?
He's going to have a bit of a zip, but there's the root. It doesn't matter. Bees is going to go down and commit the suicide.
Himself. It's okay. Overgrowth only has 70 second cooldown.
Yeah. He gets the Overgrowth, but that's the whole thing, is he's able to just... He doesn't care. And now the bear... farming. And look at Already, look at this net worth chart, YJ. It's spiked up so much. It's now over 7,500.
No.
And if they find Avril?
It's Shadowblade, my gem of true sight on this bear. Okay, by dust.
Honestly, if they just get a gem on this bear, they're gonna be fine.
Oh, they bought this gem on the bear!
Yeah.
Okay, ET killed tree and protector.
Brawls is gonna go down. But it took them four heroes being in mid, and now they're doing what they need to do, and that's stick together as five. Now we're gonna see some damage.
They can't hit the bear, the miss chance is too strong.
And even if they can, then there's gonna be a Pudge and a lifesteal that they have to deal with. And now the bear's
they're
just gonna walk
dying.
Away.
They're actually dying to the bear. Burst, both at the same time.
There you go.
Oh, there we go, that's the damage I was waiting for. The cross kill's useless, they can't get the kill. AA is dead, so what if you have bursted? It's too weak.
And the funny thing is that they spend so much time assimilated that it's already off cooldown. Pudge is already inside, his tranquil boots are about to come off cooldown, and they're back in the bear!
Oh no! Dire's middle tower is under attack. Oh, the pipe pickup. That's gonna be what you need, but I'm not sure if it's strong enough.
Well, the thing is, it's gonna come down to this alchemist. He has done the, you know, the cheese. Is he going to go for another Ags for the tree, or is he just going to try to transition and use this space into being, you know, regular carry, and, you know, then come into this in the late game and be prepared? Maybe he gets an Abyssal of his own. They can then deal with the Storm Spirit. They can deal with the Slark as long as they time it with the Dark Pact. But in the meantime, this bear is just able to push down all these towers. Midasing, killing off the creeps, and then just going in and letting that Desolate go to work. Demolish,
yeah.
Desolate.
And AC on Nyx.
God,
so the bear's gonna. Yeah. The AC on Nyx. What else do they need? I don't know. We probably stack like Aether Lens on the Pudge.
Vlad's would make sense. They could pick up
Vlad's
and just get that. You know, another one of those like sort of little
ETs,
items.
ET is dead.
And this is one of the downsides of ET is, you know, you start that Echo Stomp.
Look
and
at
then
that.
It will get canceled.
Yeah. Look at that. The pipe. He used the pipe already, but it's still dead. And now, okay, so we've just seen how useless the pipe was. What is your opinion on that?
I think it's the right idea. We're gonna see these zip out here. It's the right idea, but unfortunately, I'm not sure if it's too little too late, but they need to stay as five. You know, you saw in that last fight, even when they were five, they can't go against this bear. He's so strong.
And now
Slark's
dead. He's dead.
It's just, you can't do that.
Oh god, Pudge has 18 flesh sheep stacks because he's in all of the kills. Holy shit.
And worth mentioning, there have been 20 kills on the side of Slayers. Pudge has been a part of 18 of them. Follow Me has been a part of 17 of them.
Oh god, it's a pipe of insight and a Vlad's offering on the Pudge.
Rawl's coming in. He may look to spend the overgrowth here. No, he decides better of it. And, you know, look at the map. Look at how much control Slayers has. If they can get a ward up anywhere in this mid area here, maybe take control of the Roche Pit, they're going to have such a huge vision advantage. And then you look at the vision of Flying Snakes, they have almost nothing. They can't even get out of their base.
That is one rich courier. Look at that.
Wow.
Just admire it for a second. All right, use the AC. Okay.
Back to the grindstone.
Oh, they have the Maelstrom Bear. The Maelstrom Bear. Well played. Now it has like 6 plus 11 armor. Oh, right, no, 6 plus 9 armor. Alright, that's pretty good.
Bees is really going to be the major factor here, I think, because he's so mobile. Until they get some sort of silence or the Abyssal Blade to get that instant lockdown, Bees can be really—he can really be the difference maker. Excuse me, because he can go in, he can make these split pushes, he can make these deep plays, and then just zip out. He may only have 6 charges on the Bloodstone, but that's enough to keep him healthy and get out if he needs to.
Yeah, good point. Good point. And I think what you're saying is completely right. The thing about that is that by the time Lundrid gets off the Abyssal Blade, I think they will just win the game if this continues at this rate.
He's not going for the Abyssal, though.
What is he going for?
Is it on the bear? No, he's got the Maelstrom.
Maelstrom.
Whoa, tree's dead. No, tree's not dead. He's going to get the invis. Swaggoo doesn't want to spend the chrono. He knows he could get the kill, but he knows he needs that chronosphere. He knows how important it is. Avril will come in and clean up.
Whoa.
Okay. ET is dead. ET is dead. Just casually saying. Okay, a pile of insight is not going to help you at all, okay?
There's nothing they can do about this. He's diving the tier 3 towers against two heroes, canceling the stomp. He'll kill him, and now look at the damage he's getting into the tower. Demolish is so outrageous. You get so much damage off of it. They're trying to split push. They're trying to take top.
He buys TP scope. Oh, this TP is the man. Here comes the big man himself. They're going to chase the slot because they have vision of him. He may have pounce, but let's keep chasing. There we go. The maximum movement speed bear. Oh, he pounces not across and now he's dead. Sheridan's not gonna help. The roar as well. Regen rune on the corner, but yeah, Slug's dead. He can't dispel anything. If the root happens now. Actually getting pulled. Bear being pulled in. What does he wanna do? He wants to continue on his conquest. I think the bear needs a blink.
Blink on the bear would be they're committing so much for this, but they have a 15,000 gold lead and game one in their pocket. So even if this doesn't work out, they can go back for game three and be fine. Or if this doesn't work out in this game, they still have a 15,000 gold cushion.
He's ratting.
YJ, he's not ratting. He's bearing it. He's bearing the weight of this game.
Tree
goes down.
BKB on this stone.
You know, we talked about bees and how he can be the difference maker. He has the BKB. So he's going to be able to make those plays. I think if you're Rawls, you're kind of okay with that happening because, you know, we talked about Tip to Strip. How is he going to transition? He's still sitting on the Maelstrom. I don't know where his gold's been going, to be honest.
Yeah, I don't know either.
You know, I feel like we're spending so much time following this Spirit Bear, but really he is the most exciting part of this match.
I mean, he's the one that's doing all the work. Everything else is just okay. We have Alchemist that dies to the Storm Spirit. Nothing he can do about that.
Beast has got to be careful. He's got no mana. And now they're going to jump out. They're going to try to get the Dismember.
Oh,
yeah.
Dismember.
They get him anyway. Was it the Radiance Burn that killed him? Oh, they messed up their assimilate. They got to spend 50 seconds not assimilated. Wow, guys. You really let that window close on you.
Yep.
Whew. 900 gold.
Okay. Now they can buy the items. We have the Guardian Greaves coming up for Pudge. We have what's here for Nyx? He's seeing Orchid Malevolence. Is he? Oh no! He's gonna put it on the bear, isn't he? It's Orchid Malevolence bear.
This is the fattest bear that I've seen in a long, long while, for 36 minutes. You mentioned the Greaves. Are you able to trigger the Greaves if you're assimilated?
No, you can't.
I would think no. Okay.
Yeah, I think he's just gonna get it for the aura.
Man.
But what is Nyx going to do?
You know, I want to look at the other side of the river. I want to say, what's Avril going to do? It looks like he's working towards the Scotty. He has an Echo Saber. He has the Silver Edge. I don't know if Scotty's going to be the item that he needs.
Yeah, he needs MKB. He needs the damage.
He needs MKB. He needs BKB as well.
BKB. Yeah, he needs both bars. All right.
I think the BKB first would work out because that's going to let him resist the damage. And it's going to allow him to not worry about the mischance. And now,
Roshan?
Are they going to Rosh? Okay.
No.
We both reacted to that immediately. Like, oh my gosh, are they doing this? Oh! Silence! Oh! He's cleft! He has the TP scroll, but he's dead anyway! Just pop out! Oh, if he had just popped out of the infest, I think they would have had the damage there.
I think they know he's gone. Yep.
You know, we talked about how this wasn't working out early game and they weren't getting the kills that they needed, but, you know, it was right around this mark here, you know, maybe 20 minutes that, you know, they stagnated through here, and then they just took off. They started finding the kills. I really think that it was the Ag Scepter on the bear that allowed them to do this, because those roots, and more importantly than the root, the threat of the root is so crucial to making this work. And now, look at this. Rawls now has his own Ag Scepter that he bought with his own money. Fancy that, someone buying an Ag Scepter for themselves, and now he's just warding up the jungle.
Yep, very smart play there. Oh, the courier could be sniped down. No! It's holding the Skullbasher! It actually delivers! He misses entirely! Skullbasher on that Ice Killer. Lifestealer.
Once again, I think that they could have popped out of this and then gotten the hook into the Dismember onto Bees, but they seem to be really committed to this, and with good reason. It's been working out for them for the last 10 minutes or so, and I think it's, again, we said at some point they're going to have to transition out of this, and the question is how they're going to do it. There's the Overgrowth and the Orchid onto the Slark. He's now feared, and they just surgically clean him up. Tree and Protector, that support, right-clicking for 170 damage.
Yep. And he does have the bonus minus armor, as in there's the negative armor aura from AC.
And now the bear looking for the void.
No, he's going for a... I bet he's gonna run past the Storm Spirit.
Just go right in.
Oh no, he's not. Oh, he goes in. Oh, the fear! So he can't TP. Well played there. Where was he TPing to?
I think he was trying to go to top lane, maybe try to keep pushing that in, or perhaps he was just trying to TP out to be safe.
I think the bear needs some sort of mana, because he doesn't have the mana for the Orchid Malevolence now.
But even so, okay, so what? You know, it doesn't even really matter all that much, because they can still just get the root procs, and that's enough for them. All he needs is enough mana for the roar, and he's fine. And then he just, you know, crosses his fingers that they get that root. What percentage is it? 20? Yeah, 20% chance for root. And they can go out. They can go up against anyone. They can even, we saw earlier, they go up against the entire enemy team. And it works out just fine for them.
Yep. Well played. So what is coming in on the courier here? That is a energy booster. Oh, yeah, that is the Guardian Greaves coming out. And Basher is second. Wait. Oh, he's going Abyssal Blade now.
Bees jumps in onto Alchemist. He's got the armlet off. He hasn't been able to get... He does have the ult. Bees has a lot of damage, but Tip the Strip is regening a lot. He gets the armlet toggle. He's going to try to keep running away from this. He is going to get the toggle. Bees now not with enough mana.
Oh, Diffusal Blade.
He's going to find himself in a bit of extra trouble. Okay, Bees will get out. But man, oh man, that could have been... that was close.
Yeah. So Tip the Strippers has the BOTs now, but other than that, the entire jungle has been farmed by our lone druid friend here. He's not been disturbed a single time ever since they got the bear online.
And you know what's interesting is it's almost like Follow Me is farming. This entire draft has been one player farming for another, because it started off with Tip to Strippers. He got the Ag Scepter online, gave it to the Lifesteal.
Oh, Void's dead.
Yes, sir, he is.
He actually defused the bear instead of him. I think he panicked.
Can you defuse off the root? I assume so. It's like you only need like
Because you can defuse off silence and the root. He got silenced. He defused the bear instead of him. And now Demolish is gonna... Oh, Demolish is gonna work miracles. Look at that. 1, 2. Wow.
They try to combo the bear, but they're a little uncoordinated. I think that this is a strategy that can really get in the head of your enemy. And he doesn't even care. He's just going to eat the cold feed. Oh, never mind. He's just going to walk away because he has 522 movement speed. There's the stomp. And once again, he's just going to walk off the cold feed.
Yeah, he's got a steamroll in.
He's at half health, but he can be fine with that. And then he just gets... Look at that. He
catapult.
Just gets called back.
Yeah, the catapult's going to get it. Definitely. Oh! 6 HP.
But Bees walks away. He's another player. We haven't seen any farm progression for him. He's got the Orchid, he's got the BOTs, he's got BKB, and he's got Bloodstone. I feel like that was what he had 15 minutes ago.
Yeah, that's exactly what he had since earlier. But the courier is going to deliver to him that Mystic Staff.
So looks like he's
out. So he's going in for Hex stick.
You think he'd go Hex instead of the Shivas?
Yeah, I think he's going to go Hex.
I think that would make sense, but at the same time, so you Hex the bear, then what? He's not having trouble picking anyone else off.
Yeah,
No, seriously, think about this. You Hex the bear, there's still Radiance Burn, there's still Rot Damage, and even so, great, now you've killed the bear. Now you get to contest with the
Lifesteal. Oh, no, he's dead if he actually... No. If he gets the Abyssal Blade from... No, he's going to do the TP thing.
Avril has finished his Scotty.
I don't think that's going to help a lot.
Yeah. And again, I want to go back to this. Follow Me, he's farming items for another hero. He's farming items in the jungle. He's going to wind up finishing that Abyssal Blade. And then guess where the Abyssal Blade winds up? On the Spirit.
Yeah, it's already on the Spirit Bear. He does have the Abyssal Blade. He's going to red top, isn't he? He's going to roll all the way to top lane.
He's going to try to, but he doesn't have creeps anywhere nearby, so it's going to be a little tough for him.
No, it's only going to be one hit. Tower's one hit. Look at the HP. It's 6.
Ah, well then. That's a free tower. Thank you very much. See you later. And now he calls the bear back. Avril and Swag.
Oh, no. Avril's dead if he doesn't get a good pounce. Oh, he pounces there instead of up a cliff?
Follow me. Looking for this. He gets the right clicks. There's the slow. There's the
silence.
Spirit Bear comes in, he's doing
his work. Oh, the root into Abyssal. Fear being thrown out, but it's not good enough. Gem of True Sight on the Pudge, inside the bear.
Gosh, it's so hard to keep track of these items because, you know, I'm used to clicking around on the map and seeing.
Oh no, it's the Blink Dagger Bear, that's what I've been calling.
And this gives them so many options. They can blink and then pop out and then dismember. They can blink and then root. They can blink and then try to hex.
Abyssal.
Silence.
Oh no, Storm is not prepared for this. He's not prepared, he's dead.
Even with them stacking their stuns like that, they're still fine. They had the silence and the fear at the same time.
Oh, Swaggo. The blink. Oh my god.
Good lord. Somebody call PETA and tell them that they're doing great work because the animals seem to be doing just fine today.
Oh, God.
Okay, serious question. How do you recover from this if you're Team Flying Snakes?
I don't know. You need to find some way to kill. You just need to kill this. But take a look at Pudge. He has 24 Flesh Sheep stacks, okay? And that's a lot of Flesh Sheep stacks. And he is so tanky because he has magic resistance. He has healing. He has lifesteal. He has a bit of movement speed. And Nyx has the Basher, Radiance, AC, Vanguard. They're going for a second Abyssal Blade. And now Slug's going to toe-to-toe against the bear, which is actually, honestly, not good at all. Because it can tank all of that substance and punch even more back.
And he doesn't even care about the cold feet. He kills the barracks despite the fact that he's under the effect of cold feet. Then he walks away.
Yeah.
Working out really nicely for them.
Slug is really good against heroes. The thing is that Spirit Bear doesn't have stats to steal. Yeah? You see what I'm saying?
Is that true? Oh my gosh, you're right. I never realized that.
Peace. You don't have to be sarcastic.
No, I'm not being sarcastic. I actually didn't know that.
Really?
I did not know that. Yeah, I mean, it
makes
sense.
Oh, no, it's Easter.
And a haste rune. Oh, my gosh. He's just hunting.
Oh, he's going for a Storm Spirit because he has the Blink Abyssal.
And Storm Spirit has no idea this is coming. They have no vision. He knows exactly where Storm is. There's the Blink. There's the Silence. There's the BKB, but the root comes through it as well as the Abyssal Blade. He is going to try to get the zip away. BKB still
okay,
taking
he has
down.
Bling.
Long,
he has
long
bling.
Zip
he
away.
Chase.
B's going to be all right. Oh my gosh, or is he? There's the fear.
Oh, he gets it. He gets it. Keep chasing. Your Blink's up in 5.
And B's with no mana.
Left. Okay, he gets sleep, but they have to run. They can't fight this bear at all. And he gets recall back.
And now the Abyssal Blade coming out for Lifestealer.
Oh my god.
So now they have 2 Abyssals. If they need them. They have the already unkillable Spirit Bear. Getting the AC aura, getting the Vlad's aura. Getting the Pipe aura, getting the Drums aura. He's got a Mjolnir of his own. He's got a Silence. He's got a Blink. He's got an Abyssal. And then you look at the Lone Druid. What's he got? A Maelstrom. He's got a Midas. He's got Brown Boots. He's got a, you know, Morbid Mask. He's just farming. Farming. You know, he's playing PvE. He's playing some Warcraft 3 against casual bots right now.
There's still a few things the Spirit Gang can get. Sell the Midas. You still have an extra slot there. Eat the Moonshot. Die like that, sure, it is dead. Oh, they burst up for some reason. And now there's a big opportunity. Oh, never mind, it's too late. ET was slow on the upkeep. And so was the Slug.
Are they gonna find the void though?
They don't have mana for silence, and that's the big thing there. BKB gonna be built on the void here. Oh, the bear actually coming in with the roar, wants to get the tower, gets resummoned back. I think it's because he has no mana left.
And they do need mana for this combo to work out. Maybe they could build some sort of mana aura item. Something like a... Well, I guess they have the Vlad, so never mind. They have some mana regen. Regenerating 0.8 mana per second. Not too terribly much. And they're going to find the Storm Spirit. They get the bash. They don't have the silence to follow up. Oh. I think that that's where you pop out if you're Storm and you start dismembering that guy.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, actually, I guess it would have to be... Because the Lifestealer would have to pop out if Pudge was going to pop out, right? Or can Pudge just pop out of his own will?
Pudge can pop out on his own.
Okay. And I mean, not for nothing, there's also an Abyssal Blade on the Lifestealer. So he pops out and then he's fine.
Yeah, just chain your stuns together. Okay, so what is... Oh, they're buying something. They're thinking, Pudge has 4,200 gold. My Shiva's gone for the aura.
And they have the gem on the Pudge as well. And now the bear with his own BOT, he's so mobile. Oh, they're going to run into Storm Spirit. No root. He missed the fear. Again, I feel like popping out there to secure the kill is pretty okay, considering the Storm has 4 Bloodstone charges. You know, Lone Druid is a hero that doesn't see much play, and I think it's a little bit unfair that they're doing this to him. Oh, there it is. There's the stun. They have the silence, the BKB. But again, Pudge can pop out and dismember that. And I think that they...
Yeah, but I think they shouldn't do that because the rest of the team is there. And if they are separated, they're easier to kill than if they are one big entity.
And not only that, but there's also the fact that they just used it, so it's going to be on cooldown. They're not going to have an option to reassimilate. I want to say it's a 50-second cooldown, if memory serves me correctly. They have the BOTs, but... Oof, Bees manages to kill the creep they were traveling to. Gets up onto the high ground, and he's going to try to TP home, but there's the root! Oh, by a bash!
Oh,
another
silence.
Root! They don't have the mana for the silence!
No. The stun again! He can't get up!
I am astounded at that RNG there. He had a bash, and then he had a bash, and then he had a root, and then he had a bash, and then he had a root. Man. You know, I know there's no Spirit Breaker, but it still feels appropriate to say 17%.
Buying the armlet.
Armlet for who?
Nyx, apparently. But it doesn't affect the bear, though.
I don't know why he would need an armlet.
Yeah.
But, you know, not for nothing, despite this giant lead that they have...
Wow, there's a 10-second BKB!
You know, honestly, I think that's okay, because they don't need the BKB for a sustained fight. What they need is just to escape the initiation from the bear. So I think as these BKBs tick lower and lower down to 5 seconds, they're not going to mind, because all they need is that brief interruption so that they can get away. And then they're fine. They're comfortable. They're happy.
I see another eggs being built by Alchemist.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack. Dire's structures
are I guess you would give it to... himself?
Pudge?
I don't think giving it to Pudge is the play, though, because he doesn't need his dismember to... he's not using the hook, so he doesn't need the reduced cooldown.
Yeah, I guess so. But and you can't give it to the... Can you give it to the bear?
That is a very important question.
Can bear eat moonshot?
Well, it's a hero creep, right?
Yeah, it's a hero creep.
So I don't think that it can. Although it does have an inventory, so I don't know. That's something I'm gonna like have to go in and test in a test lobby. There's the Ag Scepter for Alchemist. Not sure what he's gonna do. There's the blink onto Slark.
Oh!
Get the Abyssal.
Oh.
Avril walking away. We see the roots coming in. The bear still goes in. He gets the fear. There's a Glimmer Cape there to try and save him. Glimmer Cape's a great idea, but is it going to be enough? Looks like Avril's just barely going to waddle away. But now the bear turns his attention onto Bees. There's the stomp. There's the cold feet to follow up. This bear does not care. He'll go anywhere.
He just wasted everything.
Man, and he's just destroying this tower. And then he just gets pulled back. Zero risk, tons of reward. And now the Alchemist Illusions are laying siege into the top lane as well. This is a melee barracks, so it is going to regen. But, man, The Glimmer Cape, I think, is a great idea because it's going to give that extra magic resist and allow people to get away from the bear. But I just don't think it's going to be enough. They need two or three more Glimmer Capes, to be honest. Here's the bear. He gets pulled in by bees. Avril trying to chase him down.
Oh, he could die this time. Living armor. Oh, it is dead. But here comes. They pop out. And now... Rage. Come on. Oh, that's all of the business there. I am stunned, to say the least, that they let that happen.
Yeah.
The gem of true sight on the ground.
I think they popped out a little bit early. Flying Snakes has got to be really happy with this. They just got a massive amount of gold. There's 6,000 gold for those three kills. Are you kidding me? It was an 8,000 gold swing just for those three. That was how they need to play it. But now here's the bear. He's back already. He's going to get the Abyssal. He's going to get the Roots. He's going to get the Bashes. Jeez. I don't know how you're going to deal with this bear. And, you know, yeah, okay, so Pudge and Lifestealer are dead for another 60 seconds. But as soon as they come back, can they do that again? Can they kill the bear and then kill both heroes inside again? That took all of their heroes. It took a Chronosphere. It took an AA ult. It took an Elder Titan Stomp. It took an Elder Titan Earth Splitter. It took everything that they had to make that happen once. And if any one of those pieces was not in position, it's just not going to happen.
Yeah,
not to mention,
it's time to build BKB on Bear.
Tip the Strippers is now... He's almost a formidable opponent in his own right, despite the fact that he's been quiet for most of this game. 365 last hits. He has a net worth... Oh, excuse me. I didn't bring up the net worth chart. Net worth of 22,000 gold. To compare that to the highest hero on Flying Snakes. He's only down by 5K.
Yeah, it's pretty good. Pretty decent there. And, I can only see the Lone Druid bear getting harder and harder to kill because they have to waste these big outies just to kill the bear. And what that means is that whenever it's down, there's no way to kill the bear. Now Pudge has Aghanims now.
And even if you do kill the bear, then it becomes a 5v5 team fight with a Lone Druid who's farmed, an Alchemist who's farmed, a tree who has a Radiance in his own right.
Wow, he has Radiance.
I mean, usually traditional wisdom says not to stack Radiance, but I mean, they're doing it. They don't care because they know that the tree is away from the others so often that if he has that, he can scout and he can get that extra bit of damage. If one of them goes down, there's the mischance from the other. It's still going to force the BKBs, the MKBs.
So what's happening now? Something on the courier? No?
No, nothing on the courier. We do see that that 8,000 gold swing, yeah, just a tiny little spike in the net worth chart. Slayer's still far and away ahead. And now there they go again. Back to work. Soul Booster now on the bear.
What do you think that's going to be? Octarine Call?
Probably the Octarine for the mana regen, I guess? Or maybe just the lifesteal.
Yeah, I guess so. The bear can actually just go for a rat. Oh, okay. You could get stuck. That works too.
You know, he needs a Quelling Blade. He can't go south from there?
Battle Fury.
Oh, he can't go south from there because there's that tree.
Blink.
Now we see the TP back. Bees is here. He has the Sheepstick. He has the Shivas. Lots of item progression for him since the last time we talked about it.
ET is dead.
ET is dead. That's a pretty good point. Oh, baby. They do have a handful of heroes here. Rawls is going to spend the overgrowth. We're going to see the Spirit Bear will get cold-feeded up. Rawls has the living armor. There's another stomp on top. The tree will go down. Is the bear going to get out? Bear will die, but now we see the pop out from the other two. There's the AA ult. There's the Slark. Regenning. The Earth Splitter on top. Spork is trying to go to work. He's getting some hits here. There's the Dismember onto Bees. And now Spork is trying to go back in. He manages to get in onto Bees. And
nice.
Then he eats the Pudge.
Assimilate.
He saves the Pudge, so he's going to be okay. And he's fine from the AA ult. And now
the
bear's
back! Oh no! This is GG! They can't defend without all the crossbows and all of the things!
Yeah, look at all the spells that were spent there on the side of Flying Snakes. They don't have... The only one of those that they're going to have soon is the AA ult. Man, and there's no buyback for either the Slark or the Elder Titan. I think Flying Snakes... You're staring down a barrel here, especially with that root.
Nice bash, abyssal, fear, stun lock. Oh, he dies. That's a buyback, but tree charge, bloodstone. That's gonna be, is that all three Rexes? We have Alchemist hammering down one. The bear is on the other side. He goes for the Alchemist instead, but the bear doesn't care. He's going in. He's getting cold feeted, but he's just going in for the Rex.
And they know, that
frozen in place.
They know that the Alchemist is a low-hanging fruit, though. Can they get this bear, though? They're gonna kill the bear, and then it looks like he's got a lot of regen, but he will wind up going down here. Then the pop out. There's the dismember and the abyssal. They did stack their stuns. Can they get just a little bit more onto Bees? Oh my gosh, no, they can't. Bees is going to zip away, and he's going to be fine. Argos goes for the blind hook. Doesn't quite get it. Spork trying to clean up, going in onto Valkyrie. He's just going to back off.
He's okay.
And now they're going to get
this
Rex.
Assimilate. Rage. Nicely done. Assimilate sometime soon. Oh, Chrono Spear is up. They've overstayed their welcome.
And you know the funny part? He's only worth 723 gold. And now Arglis tries to turn around and fight this. But again, he chooses the right choice. Just go right-click the barracks ones. They have two full lanes of racks. Yes, okay, they just gave up another 7,000 gold swing. 7,700. But they're fine with that. They have buybacks on all three of their heroes. They won't have they have their bear resummoned. Excuse me. And it's already going on cooldown. The net worth chart has barely taken a hit. So
actually, the net worth chart has risen in the side of Slayers again.
I don't know why they bought back on the Pudge. I guess they fear this push. This is going to have to be an all-in for Flying Snakes. This is when they have to make it happen. They need to force the buyback, and there it is. And now they're just going to back. That's definitely the right call. They cannot afford to lose a fight here.
Bloodthorn on the bear.
Bloodthorn finished on the Spirit Bear. Good lord. Even more damage. Hey, tell me this, YJ. Can a Radiance crit?
I don't know. Does it register as...
I don't think it can. I don't think it can crit. I also don't think that the rot can crit.
All attacks.
All attacks including spells?
No, I know. No spells. Just attacks.
Just attacks. Okay.
Just attacks. But that's more than enough. It's more than enough without the Chrono Spear.
And now Slug's Abyssal into
nice
Fear,
dash.
Into the Root. Silence still rooted. Avril trying to get away. This time makes a smart play. Pulls the bear back. They know that too many times they've done that, and then the bear gets gone on. And with Lone Druid not with another resummon for 35 seconds, and buybacks on cooldown for both the Lifestealer and the Pudge, they cannot stay too hard like that.
The Alchemist has to be nearby. He's actually getting an Abyssal Blade off his own. What about the tree? The tree is 5k gold.
Sitting on 5k gold on top of a Radiance and an Ag Scepter. Now, what's your next item as a tree? Do you start building for some sort of wacky right-click tree?
Refresher,
actually. That could be a huge impact here because, like you said, those BKBs getting on cooldown, if they are on cooldown and the fight happens, yeah, they can break the root with the BKB, but then if you BKB or if you ult a second time after you force the BKB, it pierces magic immunity. So it's going to hit all three heroes even if they're BKB'd, and that's going to be a huge difference maker for them. I also want to mention, there's no gem for Flying
Snakes.
They can't carry a gem.
You mean Slayers?
No, I'm saying Flying Snakes can't carry a gem. They have two, but they're not using the gem to clear out the trees. They're too scared of losing it.
Well played. Very smart there.
And you know what's funny is that Slayers can buy another gem in 3 minutes. They're fine.
Yeah, they are. The bear's being scouted out here with these obs wards, but they don't see the tree line. Nor do they see the treant protector who's buying hex stick. Oh, here they come. And the bear has vision. He doesn't want to get caught in the huge crossbow. Goes to BOT red top.
Smart play. He knows there's no one there. He knows that they all must have committed because he knows that if they don't, that they can't take the fight. And now he's going to walk into mid. He's going to blink forward. He'll hit it a
recall.
Couple times and then just get summoned back. Man, return. Great ability, guys.
Yeah, and that's two hits on the range rack, so four more hits and that thing goes down.
And then they're already staring down two lanes of super creeps. I don't think they can handle mega creeps because this already, again, go back to the vision game. Look at how far this is pushed up. It's all the way up to here. And you look at the vision for flying snakes, they can't even get out of their own base to ward. So if they can manage to get super creeps, I'm sorry, mega creeps, I think that flying snakes is going to have to, I don't know. I don't know how they can come back from that. It's going to have to be rapier on your Slark. I guess Slark can survive this assault.
Yeah, but Slark is a bad rapier carrier. Rapier on the Void, so he can hit while in Chrono, maybe? But Overgrowth kind of counters that?
Well, the Void does have Time Walk that I believe you can Time Walk out of Overgrowth, right?
Yeah, you can Time Walk out of Overgrowth.
Because I know you can't blink out of it.
But you waste time going in and out like that.
I suppose you're right.
And every time the bear dies, it's always been at the end of Chrono Spear. So that means that they need to have people hitting in. Is that MKB on the bear? That's MKB on the bear.
That's MKB on the bear. Preemptive. I don't know what he was going to do with the soul booster then. Maybe he changed his mind halfway through it. But, you know, we mentioned the Octarine. There is an Octarine on tree.
I get it. It's the Octarine core on the Laundry so he can spam Rabbit.
Ah, okay. As well as getting a reduced cooldown on the bear should the bear die.
Yeah, but why not the bear go into Laundrit true form so he can like buff? You know, because you get a new spell, the battle cry thing.
You know, I don't think he needs it. I also think that isn't it a radial buff around Lone Druid? It's been a long
really?
Time since I played Lone Druid.
Yeah,
so
I've never played Lone Druid, man.
I know that it's a buff for both him and the bear, but I think that it's a buff that Lone Druid casts, and then the bear gains in an AoE.
Oh,
so if he's
I
not
see.
With the bear, then obviously it's not going to benefit him.
Yeah. He has to transform and let us see.
Please no flame. Please no flame.
I think I'll go check it out right now.
And there's the barracks. Goes down, and then just the bear returns. Forced all the TPs back. All five heroes now in mid. Flying snakes. About to take a long walk off a short pier here. All I got left is this one lonely melee barracks. It all comes down to this.
Affects all units owned by Lone Druid and his spirit bear, not just him and the bear.
Wow.
And okay, so it's immediate and it gives him 130 attack damage and 20 armor.
Maybe it would be smart to start using that, I don't know. Maybe once he gets the Octarine Core, that's when he starts. Well, he has the Octarine Core. Never mind. Or me.
No idea, man. Not sure why he's making use. If he makes use of that, I think with that armor, he can tank the Slug and the Face of Void. Because it makes him a spin. You get Warcry armor.
But the problem isn't tanking the Void and the Slark. The problem is tanking the AA ult. The AA ult is what's doing all the work for them. All they need to do is get the Chrono to lock him down. Once they get the bear kind of low, AA throws the ult, and then it kills he procs it against the Pudge and against the Lifestealer. And that's where a lot of their damage comes from, because those are two heroes, especially if the Pudge... Yeah, the Pudge does have the Ags synergize now. So that's going to be his form of regen. Both heroes want to regen from their spells, and they're not going to be able to under the AA ult. Slark. Mm-hmm. Avril, you must be careful.
Yeah, but if the Spirit Bear doesn't die, they
Hang
won't pop out.
Hang on a second. Avril. The silence gets purged off immediately, and the bear's looking for a root. He gets the first hit root, but he's just going to pull back. Bees tries to zip in, but the return back. This is so frustrating for the side of Flying Snakes. They have no options here. They have no options. They've been turtling. It doesn't work. They've been trying to take the fight to Slayers. It doesn't work because look at all this vision. And look at all the vision that Flying Snakes doesn't have.
Gem of True Sight on the Pudge again. Sanjin Yasha for the bear. Well, not the bear, but Lone Druid. They go back in. No new items other than that gem.
That is going to help them to... ooh, smart play here. They're using the courier to scout up onto the high ground. Oh, there's the silence, the fear follow-up, there's the abyssal blade, but then the four staff forward. This bear might find himself in a world of hurt here in just a second. Looks like he is going to go down. Now the question is, can the lifestealer and the excuse me, the Pudge get away. There's the AA ult over top, but you're still going to see the Slark drop. We see a lot of damage going into the Lifestealer. He's getting low, but he is going to shatter. And now Pudge still with that rod on, but he's going to... No, he's not going to get out because there is...
Wow, the bash into the silence. Soul Spirits did.
And like we said, follow me and tip the strippers. They're now here. Congratulations, you killed the bear. You killed the Pudge. You killed the Lifestealer. But now you have to fight against the Alchemist and... Okay,
yeah, they had to spend buybacks for that. Yeah, it's because they spent the buybacks for that. If not for the buybacks, they would have lost.
And now,
but now everybody on the Radiant has buyback.
Yet another gem to add to the collection up here. Full buybacks on the side of Radiant. Pudge will buyback. Lifestealer will buyback. Even though there's 48 seconds before he can summon the bear again, the three of them buy back.
Yeah, well, but why doesn't... I'm not sure. Why doesn't the lone druid just... Where's he going?
Well, they don't have a chrono, so there's the hook out. Tree buys back. And now there's the dismember on the Slark. Oh, Avril's in a little bit of trouble. He's going to get hooked back, and he will go down. So that's 120 seconds without the Slark. Arglis looking forward. He tries to get the hook. He will get it onto the void. There's a TP, but he's going to get canceled. He's going to get killed. The AAL is coming down the middle, but they do not care. It hits all four of them. They're fine with continuing to push.
Yeah, I think the Lone Druid definitely has to use his battle cry.
I think it could be a big difference maker, but like we said, it's not the armor that's going to affect it, and I guess having the extra right-click damage could be nice, but I don't think that's just not the difference maker.
I guess so, but okay, we need to remember, Slung doesn't have buyback, Fist's Void doesn't have buyback, I mean, he just bought back, but Storm doesn't have buyback, and what does that mean? That means if Storm Spirit dies, they lose the game because they're one hero shot, and earlier, they needed everyone just to kill. Oh, there we go. The counter bling. Oh, so much. The Storm is dead. There's no buyback for 100 seconds. That's game over. ET out. Can't do much. Chip Protector's dead. Yes, but Phase is void. Can go toe to toe with the Alchemist. Yes, no PKB is being popped. We saw a Storm there, but Alchemist doesn't care. He goes in for the towers instead of auto attacking people. He lets the bear do the work. Alchemist is playing the tank role. And look at that business. There we go with the Infest pop up. And that's gonna GG. The best of three has been won by a spirit bear.
Wow, we don't even see the GG coming out from Flying Snakes. I think they've got to be really frustrated by that. That was such a cheeky strat. There was no GG. They must be very frustrated. I don't know what to say, honestly. It was a really clever draft. It was really bizarre. We saw it not working out through the early game, but then in the mid game, it really hit its stride. It made so much space and made so much money. I don't know, YJ. What do you think should have gone differently for Flying Snakes that game?
I don't know, man. There's not a lot that they could have done to the bear. They have to commit everything to the bear. And after that, they have to use the buybacks. They had to... I don't know, man. I'm not strong enough to say what they could have done better.
Yeah, I don't know that I am either. So apparently that was an elimination match, I've just found out. So perhaps that's why Flying Snakes are a little frustrated, because, you know, if you go down, you want to go down fighting, and you really don't want to lose to something like that. But with that said, you have to respect the ingenuity of Slayers being able to put something like this together. And, you know, in a series like this where it comes down to that one game, you know? And even in a pro game, I don't know if they would have the wherewithal to say, okay, here's what we do. That's something that I would expect to see in a best of one lower bracket match in a pro game. And, you know, I would absolutely believe that. So kudos to Slayers and condolences to Flying Snakes. They put up a great fight. They even almost were able to take that one out. But YJ, any parting thoughts here?
I don't know, man. The game was so draining just because of the bear. Oh, what a game that was. Very interesting. Very pub stompish lineup. Don't get to see that in matches, and they weren't expecting it, I think.
Well, thanks for joining us, guys. We're going to jump off here. Again, congratulations to Slayers advancing to the next round, and Flying Snakes, don't let this get you down. You guys did a great job. You fought really well. But, you know, unfortunately, it's a tough bear to crack. YJ, I'll see you next time.
Yep.